Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we have a lovely tasty dish from Maharashtra for you, and that is Usal Pav. Pav, all of you are familiar, refers to this kind of bread. This is pav. Usal is a side dish made using dry peas, also known as vatana or matar. You can get it either the green one or the, sometimes it comes as a white or slightly yellowish one also. So this I have soaked overnight. Now in the morning we'll wash this and pressure cook it. Now we'll pressure cook this for 2 whistles. Just add some water to cover the piece. Now let's open the cooker. Yes, the piece has cooked well. Now we grind the masala for the usal. So I have totally chopped about 3 onions. So some of that I'll take in the mixer jar. Remaining we'll just use it as it is. And I have taken 1 large tomato. Add a few cloves of garlic. If you don't eat garlic, you can omit it. Just a few green chilies. And we'll grind all these together into a fine paste. We have blended this into a paste. Now we also have to take a little bit of this boiled piece, and we'll grind this also into a paste and keep ready. Just about 2 tablespoons you can take, that is enough. Now take about 3 tablespoons oil in a pan. Add some mustard seeds, a few cloves. Then we'll add in the onions. When the onions are changed color, add in tomatoes. Fry that also. Cook till the tomatoes become very soft. Next, we'll add in this ground paste of the onion, tomato, garlic, green chili, and fry these masalas together for some more time. Here I'm adding some cinnamon powder. You can even use just a small piece of cinnamon at the beginning itself when you added the cloves. And this is chili powder. Use the bright red Kashmiri chili powder. A little bit of turmeric powder. This is dry ginger powder. Again, if you don't have ginger powder, you can grind fresh ginger along with the onions and tomatoes when you blend it into a paste. This is jeera powder, that is cumin seeds powder, and a little bit of garam masala. Cover it and cook it for a couple of minutes. When it starts to leave out the oil, you can see that shining oil at the side. Then this is a little bit of tamarind dissolved in water. I am going to add this. Add the required quantity of salt. And always use a heavy pan or kadai. I have used my cooker, pressure cooker base, which is quite heavy. When the masalas are well cooked, we will add in this boiled vatana to it first. Mix everything again very well together. It will take more water. Mix everything well together. Allow it to come to a boil. And while it is boiling, you can add some of the coriander leaves. It will add to the flavor. While we are waiting for the usal to boil, let's get our salad ready. Very simple. I have just taken one large onion and cut it into thin slices. To this, I am adding some chopped green chilies, some freshly chopped coriander, salt to taste, squeeze some lemon juice on it. Now mix all these well together. Finally, this is just a pinch of chaat masala. Just sprinkle it on top. This is a favorite salad at home. Uncle just loves this, either with his usal pav, with pav bhaji, with rotis, with rice, with everything. So this simple onion salad I've shown you. This is the ground boiled vatana or piece. I am adding that. Give it a good mix and allow it all to come together to one boil. Just cut the pav and keep it ready. It is boiling well and it has got a lovely color too. At this stage, we can switch it off. Our delicious usal pav is ready to be served. Usal is ready. I am just adding some more coriander leaves on top. Now to serve, you can just take the plain pav on a plate and serve it along with some usal like this. Add a few tomatoes, a little bit of finely chopped onions, some fresh coriander leaves, and here I have some namkeen. Whatever you have, if you have save, that's ideal, save or gatya. Today I have this namkeen at home. Any farsan which you have, you can just sprinkle it on top and serve it along with this onion salad. Or if you are a person like me who likes to have the pav a little bit warm, the tempting taste of butter, we can just warm it up a little bit. This is done and ready. We can just remove it from the tawa and serve it as a warm pav also if you like. For a lovely, tasty, delicious treat. And there are people who enjoy more of pav and they ask for extra pav, or people like me who enjoy more of the usal. Whichever way, you can have it for as an evening snack, or even you can have it for lunch or dinner. Just a change from your routine rice and roti. Thank you for watching the video. Do definitely try out this recipe. Subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen. We'll meet again with another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. And don't forget to tap the bell icon to get the updates about my latest videos. Thank you.